You're watching Unrelent Gaming. This is Beerus, the God of Destruction. Make sure you subscribe to Unrelent Gaming and push the like button for me, or else I'll hakai you from existence.
Oh, and do make sure to watch the entire video all the way through. And follow Unrelent Gaming on both Instagram and Twitter.
Whis, enough. On to the video.
With Dragon Ball Super manga chapter number 73 now officially in the history books, the stage is now set for the last known Cerulean survivor to battle against the Prince of All Saiyans, and with Vegeta being up next in battling Granola one-on-one, there was an interesting promise made by Vegeta in reminding the Cerulean that indeed his destruction is imminent, but are we in fact actually bound to see something groundbreakingly different involving Vegeta versus Granola by comparison to Goku versus Granola, or are we bound to see the same pattern repeat itself in Vegeta having to fight Granola only to lose by the end? As a quick little reminder before diving any deeper into the video, if you just so happen to be new to the channel and have a love and passion for all things Dragon Ball and anime related, then I do encourage you guys to smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications by clicking on the bell icon to never miss a single video posted onto the channel, as well as giving this video a big fat thumbs up by slapping that like button down below if you guys are simply excited to see how Vegeta versus Granola is going to go, because by the end of this, it's not as though fans have a bias in either liking or hating Goku, liking or hating Vegeta. It all boils down to the narrative, and I think that by the end, nobody's going to win. In fact, I think that the heaters are going to play the biggest possible role in this arc, only because this is Batman versus Superman, meaning it doesn't matter if Vegeta ends up getting the better of Granola or if Granola ends up getting the better of Vegeta, because by the end, something's bound to happen involving the heaters, and I'm calling it right now that the way this is likely going to go is, yes, I do firmly believe that Vegeta is going to be the one to defeat Granola, but Vegeta will be screwed by the end. Now, you might be asking, who's going to screw Vegeta? It's going to be the heaters, because you have to remember, the heaters are currently studying and observing and taking a look at everything happening involving Granola, Goku, and Vegeta, and they ultimately pride themselves on knowledge and control, so being the fact that they're gathering as much knowledge from this fight as possible, there is no doubt that at some point they will end up collecting the Cerulean Dragon Balls and making their wish and having that be granted, and once that happens, at some point we are then bound to see the heaters versus Granola, Goku, and Vegeta, which ironically is going to pit together two Saiyans and the last known surviving Cerulean to battle against the Heater Clan, which ironically enough, the Saiyans went on to kill the Cerulean people, so having them work together and having to battle off against the common enemy is poetic justice. But when looking at Vegeta and Granola, by no means do I think this is going to be easy, only because Granola's performance against Goku needs to be acknowledged and credited, only because he was not only able to go toe-to-toe against Goku, but he was actually able to best him during two separate occasions. So if he was able to do that, then what chance does Vegeta have if Goku failed? Which again, I'm calling it right now, Batman versus Superman, the team that makes up the Justice League, i.e. in this case, Wonder Woman, Batman, and Superman being Granola, Goku, and Vegeta, versus Doomsday, the Heater Clan, which one of them is bound to be the strongest, which might actually end up being either Gas or Alek, but we are going to be saving this topic for a later video down the road. But Vegeta in this case has one of the greatest advantages in being able to get the better of Granola, only because he was able to see, he was able to study, he was able to observe, and he was able to pay close enough attention in seeing the way Granola moved, in seeing the way Granola had operated through his fight with Goku. So this ultimately enough gives Vegeta the advantage in being able to now know what he's up against, because it's typical Dragon Ball. This often tends to happen in the fact that if there is a collective team of people that end up fighting against one person, then they're ultimately going to send one person out there in being the guinea pig or being the test dummy to see what the opposition is like. And in this case, unfortunately, the crash test dummy and guinea pig just so happens to be Goku. So is Granola in fact stronger than mastered Ultra Instinct Goku? Well, it's possible. And if he is, then I don't think Vegeta stands a chance. But if he's not, then Vegeta, in my opinion, has the absolute best chance in being able to adapt and incorporate the elements of Hakai to his moveset and really go all in by unleashing something that Granola has not dealt with when fighting Goku, which again, when referencing the end of Dragon Ball Super Manga Chapter number 73, Vegeta promises destruction. So the only thing we can hope for right now is for Vegeta to be able to control and use Hakai to the best of his ability. It would be absolutely trash to see Vegeta attempt to use Hakai and he ends up failing at it because he's simply not good or he hasn't mastered it enough, right? So that is something I don't want to see happen in this, because what's the point of giving Vegeta Hakai if he's not able to do it correctly or if he's making errors while engaging against Granola? So what's also interesting about this is seeing the display that Granola is putting out there by using similar techniques to Goku and Vegeta, and even going as far as to use similar techniques to that of the dead, such as Moro, by using the energy combustion attack that comes from within the planet. Granola is now shown being able to some extent use similar techniques and abilities, as even pointed out by Goku, in the fact that Granola is able to use abilities and techniques that are even faster than instant transmission, and Vegeta knows instant transmission as well, so we're gonna have to see which one of the two is going to be faster in this battle. But at the same time, there have been so many people pointing out that Vegeta has Force Spirit Fission, and this technique is essentially useless. People forget that Force Spirit Fission is only meant to separate one's power that is not theirs, and this is Granola's power. This is what he wished for. So whether or not you like it, whether or not you think this is dumb, it's still a part of Granola. Granola didn't go out of his way to physically grab onto someone and copying their abilities. He didn't fuse with them. He didn't absorb them. He made this wish, and now having this be a part of him. So Force Spirit Fission is essentially useless. It's not going to work because Vegeta knows that by separating this, it's really not going to make a difference because this power is his. So the difference maker will be Hakai. But it's also interesting because, let's just say as an example, if Granola is without question proven to also have Hakai, then it's going to be a battle of the Hakais. And this is extremely dangerous because if both of them go out of their way to start destroying things left and right, then we can ultimately expect to see some of the Dome Cities be destroyed and some of the forests, perhaps even the planet itself, going back to what Granola had remembered when the Saiyans had invaded them just about 40 to 50 years ago. So I would love to see a battle of the Hakais just to see if Granola is able to stabilize himself versus Vegeta, who went out of his way to train with Beerus and being able to hone this for himself. So is this perhaps going to be the end of Granola? Probably not. Is this going to be the end of Vegeta? Probably not. And like I said before, this entire thing thus far is shaping out to be a battle of egos, a battle of blindsided hatred, and not realizing that the real opposition, as many of us have already pointed out, are the heaters. And I think that by the end, as soon as we get to see a weakened Granola, a weakened Goku, and maybe even a weakened Vegeta, that's when the heaters are going to step up. So make no mistake about it, I really don't think that we're going to see fusion in this arc, although it does call for it, especially if Granola ends up beating Vegeta. Then what more can you do if he's not only able to stomp out a Hakai wielder like Vegeta and a mastered UI wielder in that of Goku? So the only other solution from there would either be Vegito or Gogeta, which that fusion in and of itself would be dangerous. You would have the possibility of each fusion being able to use Hakai while at the same time also being able to tap into the powers of Ultra Instinct as well. But of course, I think that's a fan's wet dream, and I don't see fusion making its return in this arc, or at least perhaps not anytime soon, unless of course there is a time that calls for it. But right now, this is going to be centered and grounded around Goku, Vegeta, Granola, and the heater. So this is going to be a make or break moment for Vegeta in seeing what his training with Beerus did, in seeing if he's able to wield Hakai properly, if he's actually able to get the one up on Granola. But even if he does, fans have no reason to complain if something ends up happening to Vegeta if he defeats Granola by the hands of the heaters. Because by the end of it, that is exactly what I think is going to happen, because Elec even told Gas that he brought the Saiyans here for the sole purpose of stopping Granola. So what better opportunity than to see a weakened Granola at his lowest for them to kind of move on in and get rid of Vegeta and then solely focus on getting rid of Granola, in which you can ultimately prompt up Vegeta and Goku to work together in thus having to save Granola from them. But I don't expect any of that to happen anytime soon, or at least not for a few chapters. But this is going to be unquestionably the most destructive fight in this upcoming chapter, because from what it appears, it looks as though Vegeta is really looking to bring it to Granola, and by even insinuating that he wants to destroy him and destroy the so-called last Cerulean just as his own people did, it's a pretty brutal thing to tell somebody, especially if you want to antagonize them. So unless Vegeta has some kind of a death wish in prompting this guy to get even angrier by telling him about his people and reminding him that he is the Prince of the Saiyans, and that he's going to do to Granola what his ancestors had done to his family, then we are bound to see something destructive come from this, which is why I do firmly believe that the Goku fight with Granola was mainly something of a strategic, tactical-like fight and seeing them both go tit for tat, whereas this one is being portrayed thus far as being an explosive, destructive, and seemingly more intense battle than how we've seen go down with Granola and Goku. But by the end of all of this, when it's all said and done, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below in regards to four specific things, that being number one, do you think Vegeta is going to be Granola? Number two, do you think Granola is going to beat Vegeta? Number three, are the heaters at some point going to be involved soon, or are they more or less going to keep in the shadows for the time being? And lastly, with all of these references and mentions of Frieza during this arc, are we bound to see Frieza actually be incorporated physically, or are we simply going to get hearsay by Granola and the heaters, Goku and Vegeta, and not see Frieza appear at any given point during this arc? So again, I do want to get your thoughts and feedback in the comment section below. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. I personally wouldn't set my standards so high in expecting Vegeta to get a W off the gate, because when looking at the overall narrative, there is that chance that Vegeta is going to go in there and simply embarrass himself or just simply take an L just like Goku did in having Granola beat both of them down. But at the same time, there seems to be something a little different with this, and I think that there is no doubt that Vegeta is going to put on a very good performance. If anything, we're bound to see the best performance actually come from Vegeta in this fight with Granola, but at the same time, we can't sit here and expect for Vegeta to Hakai Granola or just eviscerate him completely without there having to be a struggle being put up by Granola as a response. So again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody, and take care. Peace. And a quick little reminder before you exit the video, if you guys are unaware, follow me on my secondary channels, which are also used to discuss and talk about all kinds of different subjects and topics, including gaming and live streams, beginning with Unreal Network, which is a channel dedicated in discussing all kinds of movies, breakdowns, current events, scary stories, theories, and more. So if you are someone who is into the entertainment world, then that's the channel for you. So head on over and subscribe over on Unreal Network, which up next is Unreal Vlogs, where I bring you guys a little closer into my life and taking you behind the scenes with vlogging content, parody videos, reactions, motivational videos, uplifting videos, and more. So if you want to get to know me on more of a personal level, then that's the channel for you. Hit that subscribe button to always be in the loop with Unreal Vlogs. And lastly, my gaming channel, Unreal Royale, where on that channel we dive more into the world of gaming, ranging from all different kinds of video games, from Dragon Ball to Resident Evil to Grand Theft Auto, Halo, Gears of War, Minecraft, all kinds of horror games, shooters, RPGs, and more, including live streams. So if you're a gamer and are into the gaming world, then smash that subscribe button over at Unreal Royale and experience the ride with me. I want to thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so very much for your support, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you in the next video.
This is the Galactic Emperor of the Universe, and of course I'm here to tell you to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming.
Also follow Unrelent Gaming on these social media platforms to stay connected at all times. And if you don't, then very soon you will all be dead! Oh, did someone say Unrelent Gaming? Oh my god!
The fuck's up, Bon? Put on some clothes!
Well, why don't you put on any clothes?
What? I don't need clothes! Jesus Christ, that's huge! What, Broly?
Frieza.
Uh-oh.
Prepare to die!
Get over here! Tell these mortals that I'm the biggest Unreal Engine Gaming fan! This is my moment! I'm a part of his notification squad! Universe 7 can have all the fun! I just want the food!
And don't forget to leave a comment on this video! Show some love for the best community on YouTube!
Kakarot!